You know, I've been trying to figure out, why is it that somebody that's old enough to be my great-grandfather would be sitting up there making diss videos about me that I don't even know? And I'm sitting up there asking myself, you know, because people keep coming to me. You done made umpteen videos about me, talking about me. And I'm like, I don't even know this dude. I never did nothing to him. He's elder. You the elder, right? Aren't you supposed to be paving the way and teaching us? But instead, you just making diss videos. So I'm trying to figure out what it is about you or about me that you don't like. Then I figured it out. You know who you remind me of? I'm going to tell you who you remind me of. You remind me of the uncle that had every child in the family sit on his lap and get an erection. You remind me of the uncle that everybody is talking about in the family that had relations with all of the children. You remind me of the uncle that sat up there and told all of the little girls, you're going to be mine when you get older. That's what you remind me of. You remind me of a creep. Now, instead of you sitting up there making diss videos, you look like you've been through something in life. I mean, really, look at you. You look like you've been through it all. Why don't you tell stories about what you've been through that we could relate to? Instead of you sitting up there slandering your reflection, I mean, I'm not going to say we look like you, because I damn sure don't look like you, and none of us look like you. You look. Instead of you sitting up there slandering us, why don't you tell us some stories? Maybe we can learn something. Instead of you making diss videos, obviously you don't have a tooth in your mouth. Your mouth look like a car wreck, like a car crash just crumbled every tooth out of your mouth, which means you probably got diabetes or you got some type of sickness going on in your body. But obviously, you ain't even got your priorities together to go get you some dentures. I mean, why don't you use some of the money that you're getting off of social media from dissing the youth? Because all of us is younger than you, so we the babies to you. Even if we 40, we babies to you. But you slandering us for no reason. Dissing us. Sitting up there talking about we selling out for likes, shares, and subscribes. But then at the end of your video, you hypocrite, you sitting up there talking about family, family, family. Make sure you hit the liker and the sharer and the describer. What a hypocrite. Why don't you just do you, or better yet, reach out and say, yo, Haas, I need some help. Would you work with me? Sure, I would have worked with you. I didn't have no problem with that. But nah, instead, you got to sit up there. You slandering me? Who ain't you slandering? Who haven't you made a video about? Dragon. And it's like, damn, you out of all people. I don't like picking on people. And I respect my elders when they give me something to respect. But you stepping all over my name, disrespecting my character, disrespecting my image. You got to guard your reputation. Y'all slandering me, saying things about me that's not even true. Trying to run people off from trying to like me. But look at you. Literally, look at you. I don't even understand. I salute everybody that follow you. Because it's hard for me to look at you, literally. You look horrible, hideous. Tommy was right when he called you Mum Ra. I mean, I was thinking it, but I ain't want to be the one to say it because I ain't have no beef with you. But you do look like Mum Ra, the ever-living, transform this detained form to Mum Ra. You, and you got nerve enough to be talking. I don't even feel right, honestly speaking, making this video about you because you the elder. But because something about you reminds me of the uncle that touched all the children in the family, this is why I'm responding to you. My advice to you, I know you got sickness going through your body. The angel of death is knocking on your door. He's right there. You 1 foot in the grave. Make something out of your life. Do something that we can look up to, that we can respect. Instead of running around acting like a two-year-old, disrespecting, you acting like a toddler. You gangbanging on the internet and then trying to play innocent. I ain't even know who you was or that you even existed. But you constantly slandering me. Word of advice? Make the best of your life. You got 1 foot in the grave. The Grand Reaper is knocking at your door. You already going backwards in your baby stages. Teeth falling out. You know when you come in the world, you ain't got no teeth. And when you go out the world, you ain't got no teeth like dogs. If you going to be on social media, go get you some teeth. And leave me alone. Jumma, jumma, jumma. I ain't got no time for that. I don't know the whole song. I ain't got no time for this, man. Leave me alone. And leave the children alone, too. Because you look like that. Or do you look like that uncle that needs to turn yourself in? Now, like, share, and subscribe. Yeah, we selling out for like, shares, and subscribes. My message is powerful. And y'all know my message is powerful. And that's why you agents of Satan keep coming at me. Because it's either you working for them agencies, or you look at somebody that come from where you come from, the struggle, and you hate your life so much. That's, you don't hate me, you hate your life. That's why you keep talking about me. All of you cats, y'all keep talking about me because you hate your life. Let me live. I ain't bothering you. Stay out my lane. I'll stay out of yours. We ain't got to have no beef. Live your life. Death is just a heartbeat away. Make the best of your life, old man. Now, just keep in mind, man, with the way you look, I could have went hard with the snaps and wrecked and ranked you the same way you dragged my name. I'm being merciful. Am I not merciful? It is what it is, people.